Night. A middle-aged male of Corinth is suspected of committing suicide over the weekend. The MP for Vifor South has raised the specter of disturbances in that part of the island if government decides to continue with the DSH project. One man lives to be 100. And the DBS Sports Program 758 Sports Talk commences tonight at 8:30 with Kenson Casimir. A very good evening to you. Welcome to the Monday edition of the DBS News World. My name is Timothy Polio. Our top story, a middle-aged male of Corinth is suspected of committing suicide over the weekend. His lifeless body was discovered in his home early Sunday morning. Neighbors are expressing shock and horror at the incident, which is the latest in a series of similar matters to occur here in recent years. Just last month, a 16-year-old female snuffed out her life. DBS's Sheffield Gillard begins our news coverage.
On arrival at the scene, investigators met with emergency and other law enforcement officials who directed them to the body of a headless male lying on the ground. The head of the male was noticed next to the body. A neighbor of Paul Farnes describes him as a hard-working man and a good father who was also known as Molas. The woman who asked to remain off camera says the neighborhood is attempting to come to terms with the incident.
I don't know what triggered the mind to do something like that, but in life, people have ups and downs, they have problems, and maybe something was troubling him and he didn't want to say it and he just did what he did. But I ask that people out there, whether they have a problem, get to know someone that could assist them.
Meanwhile, during a phone interview, a consultant psychiatrist stated this recent incident is very concerning, considering the individual is at a productive age.
The suicide does not only affect the person, it affects the families. Affect the community. So it is very concerning, and every suicide is a death. So it's very concerning. I just would like to let people know that there is help and they can use the hotline, they can use the nearest health center, they can speak to somebody. Anybody who's contemplating suicide needs to speak to somebody.
Dr. Jabatis believes that it would be more difficult for men to come in because of the ego and how they are perceived in society.
Men think that when they discuss problems that they face in our emotional concerns, they consider to be weak or they consider to be quote-unquote boa, as people would say. So they have some difficulties. And even if you find that educated people also, if they see somebody crying, they would say, oh, that man is weak, that man cries, we don't want somebody like that to be in charge of anything. So that kind of thing. I mean, we have to make people realize that we are humans and we have emotions just like everybody else.
The number for the suicide hotline is 203. Investigations are continuing into this latest incident. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.
Meanwhile, one day before St. Lucia joins the rest of the global community in observing World Mental Health Day, an invitation is being extended to persons who are suffering from depression. Here is Alex Buske with more.
In light of the spate of suicides, the consultant psychiatrist at the National Mental Wellness Center, Dr. Julius Gillard, says the center is open to persons who are in need of its services. People who have difficulty dealing with depression, he says, can see a consultant or call a hotline at the health institution.
It's a more welcoming institution to persons not only with severe mental illness, but to persons who are going through difficulties with depression and anxiety and any other disorders that they might be experiencing. So we have qualified persons here who are able to evaluate and treat a lot of these illnesses.
Dr. Gillard says persons may feel overwhelmed by the emotions they go through and may develop suicide thoughts.
So for that end, we have as well the National Helpline, which is more or less a suicide helpline. So persons who are having thoughts of suicide, they can call 203 from any phone, free of charge, at any time, day or night, and they will get in contact with a professional who can talk to them about the feelings that they're having and to help them with the way forward from that. So when they call, they speak to somebody, and they, if they need a referral to a psychologist who can help counsel them, who can help lead them down a path where suicide no longer becomes an option.
For the DBS News World, I am Alex Busquet.
In other news, the island's police and customs officers are being warned against bringing themselves and their respective units into disrepute. It has come from Police Commissioner Severimon Sherry, who says that lawmen and women should not see themselves as friends of criminal elements.
They're only there to use you, and when they believe they've used you enough, they will dump you, if not get rid of you. So we need to ensure that whatever we do, we remember that as law enforcement officers, all eyes will be on us. And we are who we are when we are alone, not when we are with others. When we are with others, sometimes we tend to portray ourselves as what we are not. We are really what we are when we are on our own.
Mr. Mosheri states that a decision by one law enforcer to yield to corruption has the potential to put the lives of fellow officers in jeopardy. The top cop has also made a call for people in the region to unite in order to win the fight against crime, feels that blaming the Caribbean's porous borders for the spread of the problem ought to cease.
Because most times, there is no proof that all the contraband or illegal immigrants would have come through our porous borders. Some of them may very well be coming through legal means at our borders. So we need to ensure that we are very observant. We need to ensure that we keep in touch with the modern world and keep in touch with technology. You cannot afford to allow those unscrupulous characters to bias, so to speak, or to help us into going the wrong way.
Mr. Monsheri addressed today's opening ceremony of a joint border security workshop. It was held in the conference room of the Ministry of External Affairs and International Trade at the Bewa.